We are Stirling Autism Research, otherwise known as STAR, and this video aims to share some of our recent research. Today we will be summarising a new journal article by Ailey Cage and her collaborators Ella Perry, Will Mandy and Laura Hull called Understanding Camouflaging as a Response to Autism-Related Stigma, a Social Identity Theory Approach. So what is camouflaging? Camouflaging or masking is a strategy that masks social difficulties and enables passing as a non-autistic person in social situations. It can include rehearsing facial expressions, eye contact, and social scripts. It's something reported by many autistic people, and camouflaging is often related to poor mental health. It has been suggested that camouflaging is a response to autism-related stigma. Stigma can be defined as the discrediting of behaviours or attributes viewed as unacceptable or undesirably different. For autistic people, stigma may take the form of others shaming autistic behaviours or general discrimination against autistic people. Autistic people form an identity-based minority group affected by stigmatised social status, and we know that autistic people are frequently exposed to stigma and dehumanisation. This study used theory from social psychology to understand camouflaging. The social identity theory framework proposes that when a group is stigmatised, group members try to regain a positive identity through two different types of strategies, individualistic and collective strategies. Individualistic strategies involve dissociating from one's in-group, in this case the autistic community. This sounds familiar to camouflaging, as camouflaging seems to involve dissociating from the autistic community to pass as non-autistic. In contrast, collective strategies aim to benefit the in-group, in this case the autistic community, by positively redefining the in-group. Examples of collective strategies include joining online networks, support groups, or autism rights organisations. This study therefore aimed to investigate whether we could understand camouflaging, the social theory, and specifically we wanted to understand the relationships between stigma, the individualistic and collective strategies, and camouflaging. So what was involved? 223 participants completed an online survey, 58% female, 24% male, and 18% non-binary or used other gender terminology. Most participants were from the UK and were white. The survey had questions about individualistic strategy use, collective strategy use, stigma awareness, camouflaging, and additional questions about autistic characteristics and demographics like age and gender. We found that more individualistic strategy use, so disassociating from the autistic community, related more to camouflaging, but more collective strategy use, so advocating for and getting involved in the autistic community, also related to more camouflaging. These findings show how camouflaging co-occurs with advocating for the autistic community and strongly identifying as autistic. Stigma was strongly related to camouflaging, which shows that the autistic people feel that they must continue to camouflage in the face of stigma. In fact, being more involved with the autistic community may mean that this increases someone's awareness of the stigma and injustices faced by autistic people, and that society is not accessible or accepting of autistic people who do not mask. These findings add further evidence that we really need to target stigma and changing non-autistic people's attitudes so that autistic people feel they can take the mask off without fear of discrimination, stigma, or rejection. Thank you for listening to today's video. Please subscribe and click the bell button to be notified when another video has been made related to autism research. If you would like to learn more about our work, please follow us on Twitter and visit our website. You can also find a link to the full paper in the description below.